Sun Special! Sun Special! Precinct for the murder! Sun Special!
Yes, more news about that shocking business last night.
Have they caught him?
No, the commissioner's offering a reward of £1,000 for his capture. Only the sharpest spot him. Has the telephone man called?
Yes, he says they'll cut it off if we don't pay within 3 days.
That let him go at all. Anyway, we can't afford it. Has nobody been about the rooms, I suppose?
No.
I don't know what things are coming to. What with these new luxury hotels and service rats, they're simply ruining our... Oh, sorry, sir.
Have you finished? I'm trying to get them. If you repeat the number, I will change the line. Not through. Please, the button A. The time is up. Will you have another call? Not through. Please, the button A. Not through. Will you please, the button A? Are you there? Are you there? Hello, Supervisor.
You're
through
the call,
what's
written,
I know. I'm
starting
to call
the step button
and I can't understand what's
written. Now, gentlemen, the Bosnian government are sending Mr. Silvano, the state criminologist, with a full description of the maniac who's responsible for the Bosnian murders and who escaped from the state asylum there sometime back. Mr. Silvano is convinced that this man and the Avenger are one and the same person.
This is fabrication, sir.
On no account. I give you this information so that if any rumors of his arrival meet your ears, you'll understand they're not to be commented on. That'll do.
Is that all clear, gentlemen?
Yes, sir. Joe Martin.
Yes, sir?
Mitchell tells me you're smart enough to come in out of the rain, if you're called.
Oh, that's very good of you, Mitchell.
Now, Martin.
Sorry, sir.
I want you to concentrate on this case to the exclusion of everything else. Anything you may pick up anywhere, send it straight to the Mitchell himself. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Get on with it.
Right.
Mitchell.
Special.
Horrible murder evening special. What's that? One of them Avenger murders, surely.
Sounds like it.
What the hell are the police doing? Especially off that affair last week. You know, Daisy, it's
not like you're being out alone at night. Especially as the evenings are drawing in and the fog about.
Oh, rubbish.
Plain rubbish. And if Joe can't manage to meet you, I shall, have to turn out myself.
Rising sun to you.
Aye.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm not going to have you hanging about outside the exchange. You'll only get done with your old asthma again, then we shall know about it.
Well, there's gratitude. If anybody suffered in the silence with asthma, it's me. You wait till I'm gone, then you'll realize what a good father you've had.
Gone? Gentlemen. All right, I'll go.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I saw your card. You have a room to let?
Oh, yes, yes. Ma!
Just a minute, sir.
Won't you come in?
I think there's something to speak to, sir. Would you step up, sir?
What's that?
Only my husband, sir.
Oh, your husband. Oh, the door. Is it safe to leave the door open in London?
Oh, we shut it, don't we? Come up, sir.
Must have seen some big people in it today. It never thought of living London, would they, sir? This is our best room, sir. It's in the front. But you'll find it very quiet.
Quiet? Yes. That is very important. Oh, well, I have found just what I want. There. That's right?
Thank you, sir.
And the name?
The name is Angelo. Michelangelo.
Angelo. Oh, well, that's easy to remember.
You know, I'm a musician, and I've shamefully neglected my music lately. I'm a star for them. Oh, you have a piano? Oh, that's good. I'm lucky.
Everyone says it's a very good one, sir. We've been lucky to keep it.
Has the key that will lock the door?
Oh, yes, sir. Key's in the lock.
Oh, yes.
Mr. Gentleman, you want to see the real gentleman. Please, maybe 2 weeks to come. Oh, dear, oh, dear. I thought we were never going to have any luck anymore. We want a cup of tea. Oh, dear, you mustn't see me like this. Oh, David, yes, you take it up.
Yes.
Good girl.
Don't take on, sir, ma'am.
Yes, Rodney. Now you take it off. Oh, dear.
You're feeling better now?
Yes. I'm all right, George.
Shall I pop out and get you one?
Oh, no, no, George. I'm all right.
That's unlucky.
What?
I'll say that's lucky.
This all day?
Oh, no. I've got a job. I'm a telephone operator.
A telephone?
Hmm.
Oh, horrible invention.
Oh, I don't think it's horrible. It's very useful.
Useful? A bit too useful sometimes.
Joe, where have you been?
Thanks, Inspector.
Oh, I'm sorry, I had a conference with a big chief.
Oh, no, you're too casual.
Oh, I'm sorry, I couldn't get away.
I'm not always the same.
This is a big thing. Now, listen, Bunny, you wouldn't like your daughter to marry a man who wasn't going to tend to his
business. You know what Daisy is, don't you?
You won't you get cold, will you?
I have already. It's frozen, but delicious.
And you will ring if you want anything, won't you? I mean, for anything you please.
You're pleased to have me here.
Oh, but of course.
Oh, that is so kind.
No, you don't mean to tell me there was a copper there within a few yards.
That's exactly what I do mean, Mr. Duncan. Oh, it's Daisy.
Huh. You're a nice one, Joe Martin. I waited for you.
Sorry, Daisy. I was just telling you, Dad.
No.
I'm going to meet you. I'm fed up with you, Joe.
Here he is, Daisy. Steady, steady. Give her a chance. Big thing for him.
I should say so. It'll interest you. A woman had her throat slit in a public call box. Ha ha.
Call box?
Yes, in your district.
What time, Joe?
Well, it must have been just before you went off duty. Oh. What's up, Daisy?
Nothing, I think I must have heard it.
Heard it? Heard what?
A woman scream. Oh,
yeah.
You tell me what you know.
Are
you going to tell me what you know?
I can't now.
Oh, don't be silly. What did you hear? Come on. Come on, out with it.
Let me go, Joe.
What did you hear?
Nothing only.
What?
I heard a scream from a public call box. I thought it might be some children playing. They do sometimes.
What did you do?
Reported it to the supervisor.
Hello. Hello. Number, please, so I should think. Luggage, 4,000. Luggage, 4,000. Have you got cloth ears?
You do love your time on the switch.
Oh, oh, I... Hello, hello. Hello, who am I? I mean, who are you? Son of it. Well, why couldn't you say so? Mr. Mitchell, please. Hello, hello. Is that you, Bob? Listen, April. But it's not your own. Listen, take this down, Snappy. Red Hot Avenger story. Have just seen girl who heard victim scream from public call box.
Joe! Yeah.
Shut up! From public call. Public... From public call box.
Yes? Yes? Here you are. P. U. Bunkin. Oh, Bunkin. Where does she live?
At 12A Lytton Road, with her parents, Mr. and Mrs. George Bunkin. Yeah, got it? Yeah. 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 Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, right. Coming back now. Right, thanks very much. Oh, that takes
my biscuit. Keith, then. What is it, Mitchell?
Ben Jackson. Starting development of some group of marketing, yes? It was green with her. A public call box by one of the girls on the exchange. We'll call it tomorrow's lunch day to follow up with England football.
Sure of his bet?
Yes, Martin would be set up upstairs.
I put it for one. By the way, you get a photograph of the telephone girl?
Thanks, sir.
Will
you? You haven't touched it, sir.
No, Mrs. Bunting, I don't feel very hungry this morning. These murders, these are a great feeling about them.
Feeling? I should think there is, sir. Filthy beast. Or to be torn to pieces, whoever he is.
Beast, you call him?
I should say so, sir. Think of all those innocent girls.
But how do you know that he too is not innocent? That all these crimes are there for madness. The beast that is in all of us coming to the surface. How do you know that he knows what he does?
Of course we know he must be out of his mind, sir. All the more reason why he should be shut up and put out of his misery.
Put out of his misery. Yes. That is what should be done. What's that?
There's his young man. Me and Mr. Bunting are very annoyed with him at the moment. He's responsible for that. Dragging Daisy into it. She's got to give evidence.
Evidence? Oh, Mrs. Bunting, could you tell me something?
Yes.
When foreigners arrive in London, is there any special district that they would choose to live in?
You know what there is, sir. It all depends on where they arrive. If it was Euston, there'd be the Euston Road. If it was Paddington, I'd be round about here somewhere.
Round about here? Oh, Mrs. Bunting, would you mind removing these ladies? I'm used to bare walls, you know. Their eyes seem to follow me about.
There's an item, sir.
Not much.
Oh, sorry. I thought they lightened the place up a bit. Oh, well, if you wish, sir, I thought there was everything to do with myself. So I have to get away.
Well, you see, Miss...
Nothing yet, Pablo.
Now, tell me, when did you first realize that what you overheard might have some connection with the crime we are investigating?
I reported it to the supervisor. And although I shouldn't have done it, I tell my friend who's employed in the newspaper. Well, he telephoned his office. And that made my father very angry.
Of course your father could be angry.
What cause? Well, it's always been showing what cause. How would he like to be dragged into a mix-up like this?
Silence, sir. You cannot be heard.
Can't be heard? What do you mean, Clara? I was saying, sir...
You are out of order.
Out of order? Oh, I'm just as healthy as a
bunch
of...
Sit
down, sit down.
Pardon me, sir. I understood I was to speak what was in my mind.
Well, what is in your mind?
Nothing at the moment.
Please to continue your evidence.
Well, you see, we let a part.
So you let a part.
And what's wrong with that? You might come down to it yourself one day, you know.
One more word out of you, sir, and I'll have you turned out of court.
Sit down, sit down.
Now.
Well, you see, we live apart, and my father and mother always kept the house very respectable. And they were afraid if we got mixed up in a case like this, well, the lodger might have guessed.
Silence in court!
Right. I don't think we need trouble you any further at the moment.
Thank you.
Lizzie, go! Certainly. Let him be sworn.
Whatever I might enjoy that the evidence of such a truth shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Now, this is a most important witness, gentlemen. Monsieur Silvano, the state criminologist of the government of Bosnia. Monsieur Silvano believes that he has established the identity of the criminal as that of a notorious homicidal maniac who escaped from the state asylum at Zagreb some months ago. I state the case, monsieur?
Well, slightly. If my deductions are correct, the avenger is none other than Stefan Kurbelic, who was responsible for a series of similar crimes in my own country.
Perhaps you will be good enough to tell the jury what you know of this man.
Yes, indeed. Stefan Kurbelic comes of respectable bourgeois, or what you call middle-class family. His father is the conductor of the state orchestra, and Stefan himself is a very talented musician. He married, but it caused great unhappiness to himself. His wife deserted him in a very disgraceful manner, and this apparently unhinged the poor young man's brain. Therefore, his inveterate animosity against all women.
Liking women, I suppose. He admits himself as a bit egocentric, like. Did he come back? Yes. Don't you hear it?
Any of them going there? Come to that? Idle curiosity, as I call it. Sensational and that.
I was listening.
Why do you stay outside and listen?
Well, I don't like to bother you.
Oh, it's no bother, I assure you. Very nice to have someone to talk to. London is a very lonely place. You are home early?
Yes. I came straight home from that horrid inquest. I saw you there. Whatever made you go?
Oh, it's interesting, you know. The beginning of the chase. All the bloodhounds straining to leash. Very amusing. Not quite so amusing for the wretched hunted creatures skulking and hiding somewhere. But where?
Well, fancy you feeling like that about it.
Yes, foolish, isn't it? But, you know, I cannot help placing myself in the same position as he is, whoever he is. Oh, but, don't let's talk about things like that and think about them at all. You come here to listen to music and we talk of murder. What a silly world. The next time we will talk about less gloomy things. You know, sunshine, flowers, music perhaps. Sweet, innocent things.
It would be a bit more cheerful, wouldn't it?
Now, don't forget, the next time you come to listen, don't stay outside.
Right. I won't.
Daisy talking to the lawyer again.
Where?
On the landing outside his room.
He claimed this morning the shaving water you took him up wasn't hot.
Shaving water? It's his early morning cup of tea. Oi. Talking too much to Mr. Angelo.
Says so.
I say so.
But me, sir, never mind. A gentleman's a gentleman. He was probably only passing the time of day.
Oh, a very interesting man.
Oh, is he? Oh. Well, on second thoughts, I think you better sleep with your mother downstairs, and I'll have your room.
Oh, ridiculous.
Ridiculous
father.
Nothing. I've been a lodger myself.
He sounds all right. Oh, he is. Mother likes him, too. Can he speak English well?
How do you do?
Hello.
You're very brave to be sitting in the park at this time of year.
Well, we're just having our lunch. Miss Timms, my friend.
How do you do?
I expect it's the last little summer we'll get this year. Hmm. Better than sitting in the stuffy hatty. Well, I suppose I'd better be pushing off. Don't be late on the switch, you. Oh, don't go, Brad. Now, I've got to see a girl about a cat. Goodbye. Funny, we were talking about you when you came along.
About me? What were you saying?
All the usual things. Trying to describe you.
And how did you describe me?
Well, different somehow. Different what?
Different in what way?
Oh, you know. You can see us, ordinary people, doing ordinary things all the year round. Nothing much to look forward to.
Well, what have I to look forward to?
Oh, everything. You've seen the world, you can go where you want to.
I believe he's a kind of attractive fellow whom girls like. He leads them on a bit, and when he gets them alone, splits them up all the pieces looking for an escaped lunatic.
I interest you as a man?
Of course you do. I told you you were different.
No, no, it's you who are different. You are young and kind. You know, those two things do not always go together. Would it bore you very much?
I mean, my room sometimes.
You know, it would help to take my mind off things.
What sort of things?
Oh, I cannot tell you that. Ever.
I hate to see you sad.
Oh, but I'm not sad when I'm with you.
Oh, I'm so glad. I can't think why you came to England.
Well, you see, I was very unhappy in my own country. And then my parents suffered a very great grief. While I thought it was best to get away from all that sort of thing.
You know anything about these things, George?
No, of course not.
I knew you didn't know anything about it.
Just now you said I did.
I didn't. I asked him to do.
No?
Then I thought it was a silly question I'd ask.
Silly? No. Who was it saved up the coupons to buy it from you?
Oh, it's so beautiful, that slow path. You know, I think he must have been very sad when he wrote that. Oh, what a bit. I think someone else is very sad. The music makes him sad.
It's not so. Oh, everything. Get fond of people and things and suddenly they go away. It's all finished.
What do you mean?
Don't you know what I mean?
Of course I do. Listen. If things had been different, there might have been something very beautiful, very happy for you and me. But
what?
Oh, don't, please, don't look at me. Don't look at me. Don't look at me. Don't you know that I'm longing to take you in my arms? Don't you know that in all this silly world, there is only one who interests me, and that is you?
Then you do.
Oh, no, forget what I've said. I've no right.
But no, I don't like having that scared with him. Get him off, then he'll get a shot.
Well, if you know so much about it, come and do it yourself.
Oh, all right, all right.
But mind your head!
You're a bit late, aren't you?
Please, go away from me. Stay away from me. Don't ever be alone with me.
Don't say things like that. You've been so kind of sweet. No. No.
Don't be unhappy, please. Oh, please, don't be unhappy. I can't bear it. That is better than...
There's something frightening you, isn't
it? Yes.
Something that you can't tell me. So I'm going to tell you something. I don't care what it is. Why, you can tell me. I don't want to know. I only want you to feel that... I just don't care what it is. Whatever you are. Whatever you've done. I don't care. Make no difference. I trust you. Really, I do.
You trust me. And whatever I've done, whatever you may find out, you won't change.
Never.
Oh, why should I try something that is too strong for you?
Hello, Mr. Bunting. Dave Young?
Yes.
Oh, what's up with the lights?
Oh, the missus has gone and used them.
Where's the fuse box? I'll fix it.
Down the kitchen.
Hello, Ma. What you been doing with the lights?
That darkness suddenly frightened you, didn't it?
Not really.
Oh, I'm so happy. You've changed everything for me so much. I'm going to the market party tomorrow. We might go to that, and then we could walk back through the farm.
Wow. Oh. Quite right.
Yes.
There you are. Wonderful, isn't he, Ma? I only wish I'd been brought up to a trade.
Are you ready
for now. What with this vexation, nobody wants a butler nowadays.
Hey, well, you're quite handy, man, Joe.
No, I wish my boss thought as much of me as you two do. Oh, sorry. You know, I believe the police are on the wrong tack about these murders. They're working on the theory that it's a foreigner. They've issued a description of the wanted man.
What's it supposed to be like, Joe?
What's it supposed to be like? Hello? You here again?
Yes, Daisy. I thought perhaps you'd like to come round to the...
Sorry. Can't stop. I've got to make glad to be there.
What? What's up with Daisy lately?
Oh, she's seen too much of Mr. Angelo.
Who's he?
Very nice gentleman from the continent.
I hate foreigners.
Yes, Daisy. Daisy.
Well, Mrs. Bunting?
I was just coming up to clear away your supper, sir.
Yes, yes, I've finished.
You're never going out in a nice little piece of coat. But the fog is something awful. You can't see a yard here, don't you?
The weather does not affect me at all, Mrs. Bunting. It's very nice of you to be so concerned about my mood. But I like to be left alone. And I cannot stay in this house if I am watched and spied on.
Nobody's spying on you, sir. I'm the best
you can find, sir. Yes, I'm sure you have. I'm sorry. Please, forget what I said. Good night.
Looking at Ellen.
George, he's gone out.
He's a mad well, not like this.
Well, it's no business of ours.
Oh, no. Nobody'd go out unless they had something special to go out for. Same as I have.
Where are you going to?
Just around the corner.
What for?
Oh, get an evening paper.
Now look sharp back.
Righto.
Don't be long, George. Put on your muffler and coat.
No, no.
Don't have a look. What's it? What do you use a telephone, Mark? Hello. Luggage, 4,000.
In an hurry, ain't you?
Right. Oh, yes. I saw going to Lido with Claire, and on the way back, I ran into this packet. Mr. Mitchell, Joe Martin here.
Hey, what packet?
Oh. That you, Bob? Joe here. Got a pencil? But it's not your own. Listen, just left scene of new Avenger murder, just inside park gates. Well-dressed woman wearing white fur, gash across throat, head almost severed. I was the first press man on the spot. And when I got there, I found the wound still oozing blood. Woman not yet identified. Got all that?
Snap it in, Bob, before the others get it.
What's all the fuss about?
Can you make it a special lunch edition?
Good. Yeah. So long. Mr. B. The most horrible sight I've ever seen. Just around the corner this time.
Fancy you're being upset.
Poor journalist, you used to anything. Oh, this wasn't like anything I've ever seen before. You see, this time I was one of the first there. Oh, this fairly made me sick. It was awful.
What you really did?
Oh, don't talk about it.
What's she look like, huh?
Oh, her throat has slipped from ear to ear. What's up, Ma?
Again, the police could find no clue. 9 million people in London at the mercy of some phantom fiend. Phantom fiend? Put that down. He's like the vampires of southern Europe who used to suck the blood of their victims in the graveyard by night and never could be seen by day.
The police have brought a bit of it to England, sir.
So I hear. Chief of police from Zagreb. By gad, it beats me. Well, I must get out of the house. See that Joe Martin's on the scene of the crime first thing tomorrow morning.
Move along, please.
I wish we had here, Ark.
You mean all of this?
I'll arrange for you to see the body at the mortuary.
I should like that very much.
Excuse me, Mr. Rabinovich.
What do you want?
I'm the special representative of the Evening Sun. I wonder if you will give me your latest opinion now that you...
No, I have nothing to say.
But the English public will be very interested in anything that you might be able to...
I cannot speak.
But your English is very good.
Constable. Will you move away, please? No, I shan't tell you again.
I don't think I should let you go to work today.
Oh, you wouldn't get to the sack, would you?
It is such a silly thing to be doing all day, talking to hundreds of people you don't know.
Yes, it is, isn't it? I never thought about it like that.
Oh, by the way, what will your young man say if you're going to this concert tonight? Won't he object?
I don't care if he does. Anyway, he's much keen on his job than he is on me.
He is, and he is very, very stupid.
Morning, Mr. B. Can I use your phone again?
Well, we're not a telephone exchange, you know.
All right, I'll have you, sir. See the latest edition?
Pretty fresh.
No.
Luggage, 4,000. Can't get a word out of him anyway.
Who?
The chief of police is out there.
What? Well, they brought him over, haven't they?
Hello, Mr. Mitchell, please. Hello, is that you, Bob? Got a pencil? When interviewed this morning, Mr. Rabinovich told our representative, with the utmost courtesy, that in his opinion, it would merely be a matter of hours before the murderer was arrested.
You know, I feel very guilty about persuading you to come without your mother's wishes, but you'll enjoy it.
I know I shall.
I
don't know how
it's
going
to
be tomorrow,
is it? After all, I never get worried if I go out with the advocate.
So
why should you bother about a
harmless concert? Yeah, oh, yes. Yeah, right, Mother.
He's getting absolutely uncomfortable. I feel like telling him to mind his own business. This fancy show seems to pay for him. I can help you, so.
What are you doing up here?
I was talking to Angela. Then it gets out of your office.
Now, look here, Daisy.
Do stop on the desk. I'm getting fed up.
You're always in this room.
Want to introduce me?
Martin,
yes. How do you do? Or perhaps you don't. How do you do? I want to talk to you downstairs.
Have you arranged to go out with him?
You mind your own business.
Well, you're not going, see? Come here, Daisy.
woman was wearing a white fox fur.
That girl's crazy.
The body was found within 50 yards of the park gate.
I can't do anything with her lately.
It's estimated that the crime was committed within 3 minutes of the finding of the body.
I don't think they have any influence.
Prosecuted by the police for a man who may want to question in connection with these atrocities.
She's not gone on that chap upstairs by any chance.
Age is approximately 30. Slight build, height 5'10". Complexion dark, clean shaven, a foreign appearance. Sometimes carries black bags that are used for holding musical instruments. Real name Stephen Obelix, but probably using an alias.
Read that again, Mr. Bunting.
What's it?
Read it again.
You know, I heard the Stravinsky entry said that the great author of art is literally the foundation of all this.
And then you lean over the edge of a boat and you can pick the stars out of the water.
That's been a lot of use tonight.
What, this?
You haven't even opened it.
No. But you know, sometimes I like to follow the music with the score, and sometimes I
like the other
symphony
is better, but for me, the
skeleton
of comparison, the 50s.
Oh, but much the best. Oh, this makes me feel a very rich man.
Why?
Well, being allowed to wander in all these beautiful parks that were built by kings for their ladies. Yeah, but now they belong to the people. To lovers who have no place, no palaces where they may sit and talk.
I'm sorry we can't give you a palace. We try to make it comfortable, though.
Oh, comfortable? That's not it. Your mother seems to hate me to talk to you now.
Aunty, what's happened to Daisy? She's late. I've never suffered either.
No, just queer, ain't it?
George, you've had enough.
No, Ma, it's only the bottom of the bottle.
You can't get up in Mr. Angelov's room, I suppose.
Ah, we should have heard her come in.
I don't see.
You don't.
Oh, don't like the looks of it.
Look here. I'll pop down the road and see if she's coming.
Oh, I should. Don't poke it.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing, George.
Hi, sir.
Will be enough. Your teeth be that mad.
What did you say?
That's an old German song. Meaning, still as the night, deep as the sea. Golden shine, leave of light.
What does that mean?
That means, so shall my love be for you. You like that song?
They're pretty, those words. Don't you think you ought to give me back?
Oh, no. I like the fog.
You like the fog?
Yes, it's strange. One can feel alone. I can almost hear the stillness. Oh, I love the night. One can escape from oneself.
I thought you'd come home this way. What do you think you're doing?
Oh, it's you. Life is full of pleasant surprises.
I wasn't talking to you.
No? I couldn't believe that you were talking to an English lady like that.
Oh, shut up. Lousy foreigner.
Joe! What do you think you are, talking like that?
You're coming home with me.
Oh, no, I'm not. Mr. Angelov's taking me home.
Oh, no, he's not.
Oh, yes, he is. What's he got to do with you, I'd like to know?
Joe, I think you'd better go with him. After all, he'll treat you just like a brother.
Oh, well. You put it like that.
Good night.
Good night.
And try to dream of the Fifth Symphony.
Get back to your own country.
Not yet.
You ought to know better than to keep you out at this time of night.
You're lucky to have back at all.
Good night, Mrs. Bunting. You know, there are so many suspicious characters about it, I can't recognize it.
Right, sir.
Dirty
night, sir.
Yeah. I've been wondering about your part, and I nearly got lost.
What's your handkerchief, sir?
Mine? Yes, yes. Thank you.
That you, George?
Yes,
sir. Is that the lodger came in with you?
Yes.
Yes. Who's here? Joe brought her.
Good night,
George.
Evan.
George!
Luckett, 4,000.
Are you certain, Mr. Bunting? Hiding his face, was he? He dropped his handkerchief and you picked it up.
Yes. My hand was soaked with blood.
Your hand was soaked in blood.
His head was soaked in blood.
We're officers from Scotland Yard. What's your name?
George Bunting.
You have a lodger here known as Stefan Obelich, called Angelo.
Yes.
Is he upstairs?
Yes.
Right. Back door, front door. You stay here. Show us his room. Come along. We're officers from Scotland Yard. I have a warrant for your arrest on a charge of willful murder.
Murder?
I warn you that anything you say will be taken down in writing and may be used as evidence.
But what have I murdered?
You'll find out about that at the station.
Good.
Come along.
Be quick. Good. We're going to suppress that. They're mistaken.
Mr. Mitchell, please.
Goodbye.
Hello. Hello. Yes, sir. Yes. Back.
What? You've escaped. Get it out quick before the evening sun.
Good.
Okay. Special edition.
Very good, sir.
Hello there.
Yes, he's like a good barber, he would.
Yes, I hear he's escaped again.
He's
Number, please. Number, please.
What? Come again. Oh, I don't know if I can. Here, somebody wants to speak to you. What? Come on. Hello. Yes, it's me. Yes. Of course.
Stefan! Michel! 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 Kill you. He's been mad for years. That's why.
So I had to come here to try to find him before they hurt him.
They can't hurt him now. They can't hurt you now.